Welcome to the students of class 12. Today I will be starting a new chapter with you all, and the name of the chapter is ecosystem. Okay, so this is from the ecology part of your syllabus, and this is the second chapter. The previous one we have already discussed that, and you had that in your first unit test examination. And the second chapter from this unit is ecosystem. Now I hope you all know what is ecosystem. It is a functional unit of ecology, and it also describes or explains the interrelationship between the biotic and the abiotic factors of our environment. Okay, so ecology can be defined as the interrelationship, ecosystem can be defined as the interrelationship between the abiotic and the biotic factors of our environment. Simple. Now there are some types of ecosystem. There are a few categories like natural and artificial. What is natural and artificial ecosystem? The natural ecosystem is one which develops under natural conditions without any human support, means it has developed on its own. Okay, and for example, natural ecosystem, for example, examples of natural ecosystem include river, grassland, desert, forest. All these have been produced naturally. And on the other hand, artificial ecosystem means those ecosystems which have been created and are maintained by human beings. Okay, so human beings are creating these type of ecosystems, and they are themselves maintaining it. For example, aquarium, apiary, garden, zoo, these all fall under the category of artificial ecosystem. Clear? Next, number two is terrestrial and aquatic. Terrestrial meaning, you all know, the land ecosystem which is on the land, and aquatic means which is the ecosystem that is involving with water. Now land ecosystem will obviously be garden and forest, desert. All these are terrestrial ecosystem. And aquatic ecosystem can again be divided into two categories. One is freshwater, I'm writing in short, and the other one is marine. Okay, so freshwater is obviously lakes, ponds, and marine is obviously seas and oceans. Okay, so these are the few categories of ecosystem that are there. Moving on to the next topic in this chapter are the components of ecosystem. So what are the components of ecosystem? There are basically two components. We all know that, abiotic and biotic. So abiotic components are those components which include the physical, inorganic, organic, and topographic characteristics. Abiotic, physical meaning solar energy, light, temperature, water, humidity, wind, atmospheric pressure, all these come under. So under abiotic, first one is physical. So all these fall under physical. Next one, there is inorganic. What is, which ones are the inorganic? Inorganics include potassium, calcium, sulfur, all those. Thirdly, organic. Examples of organic include proteins, carbohydrates. Organic meaning, you all know, involving living organisms. Okay, so proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, and amino acids all fall under organic. And lastly, topographic. What is topographic? Altitude, landscape, slopes, all these fall under the topographic characteristics. So all these are the abiotic components of our ecosystem. And the biotic components include, now I will drop this, because these biotic and their different types you don't have to learn much, but the biotic components and their types and examples, all these you have to learn. Now, first one under biotic is obviously producers. Who are the producers? Those who produce food are known as producers, which are obviously the green plants, and they produce food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so the producers are the green plants. Next, consumers. Who are consumers? Those who consume the food produced by the producers. Okay, now consumers are of certain types. There are three types of consumers: primary, secondary, tertiary. Sometimes they are quaternary, sometimes not. Sometimes consumers may end at tertiary, sometimes there may be a quaternary step. Okay, so consumers are primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. What are these? Primary consumers are those who directly depend on the producers, okay, and get their food directly from the producers, meaning these are the herbivores which eat green plants. Next, secondary consumers are those which depend on the primary consumers for their nutrition. That means, for example, I will give you the examples. Secondary consumers, which are the consumers of second order, include toad, lizard, spider. These are all secondary consumers. They all depend on the primary consumers. That is, they get the energy of the producers indirectly through the producers. Okay, next, tertiary consumer. These are the consumers of the third level, and they in turn depend on the secondary consumers. Clear? And the last level of consumers are the quaternary consumers, which are the last level consumers, and they depend on the tertiary consumers and get their energy from the producers via primary, secondary and tertiary. I hope this portion is clear. Next, the other one, the third one, are the decomposers. Now, who are the decomposers? Decomposers are those animals that feed, that get their nutrition from dead and decaying organisms. Okay, suppose there is a dead animal living, dead animal lying on a forest floor. So bacteria and fungi will start growing on that dead animal and will start to decompose that dead animal, and whatever nutrients and chemicals and enzymes are there within that dead animal's body, they will start to break down slowly and will get mixed up with the soil, so that from the soil the plants can reuse those nutrients and enzymes, and thus they are not lost, they are reused. Okay, so these are the biotic components, which includes the producers, the green plants. Next, the consumers. There are types of consumers: primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary. And then lastly, coming to the decomposers. Okay. Now let's come to the topic of food chain. Okay, so I hope you have learnt about food chain in your previous classes, that means lower classes, but to give a recap, food chain is the chain like flow of energy, okay, the transfer of food energy from the producers to a series of consumers through different trophic levels in an ecosystem. Okay, so in this picture you can see that the food chain is starting from the green plants, which are the producers. Okay, the green plants, which are the producers, and then the energy that the green plants produce by the process of photosynthesis, by capturing the sunlight, the energy is then transferred to this grasshopper, and this grasshopper belongs to the primary consumer. Okay, next. This grasshopper is eaten by, I think this is a rabbit or a rat or something like that. So this is eaten by a secondary consumer. Okay. Next, this one is a cat or something of that group only, and this feeds on this one, and it is known as, it belongs to the tertiary consumer. And when the rat dies, the rat is fed by, the rat is eaten by the quaternary consumer, okay? And lastly, when this vulture dies, it is decomposed by these decomposers. Okay, here you can see mushrooms, fungi are there. So it is written that it is written here, energy is transferred between organisms when one organism eats another. A food chain is a simple linear series of steps, while a food web is more complex. So food web, we will discuss about that later. Right now we are talking about food chain. And I hope you have understood how food energy gets transferred from the producers to a series of consumers through different trophic levels in an ecosystem. Now, before ending this topic of food chain, or before ending the definition describing what is food chain, I would like to say one more thing, that is trophic level. Okay, so what are trophic levels? Each of these levels means the producers, the primary consumers, the secondary consumers, the tertiary consumers, quaternary consumers, and decomposers. Each of these belong to a separate level, and these levels are known as trophic levels. Okay, I hope I am clear with this definition of food chain. Okay, next, moving on to the characteristics of food chain. You all know that the producers are always the green plants. Here you can see the producers are always the green plants, and they will always lie at the base of, or the start or initial position of each food chain. Means all food chain will start with producers, which are the green plants. Next, the number of steps in a food chain is always restricted. As you can see, here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps, and it is generally not more than 6. It gets completed within 4 to 6, either it is 4, 5, or 6. So the number of levels are restricted. Okay, and the shorter the food chain, the more efficient it is. And obviously, always the direction of flow of energy in a food chain is unidirectional. Clear? So I hope this food chain part is clear to you all. Next, we will discuss mainly about food web and how this food web is different from food chain. Okay, so what is a food web? Food web is defined as a network of food chains which are interconnected at various trophic levels so as to form a number of feeding connections amongst different organisms of a biotic community. So you can see here how from the green plants, so there are two green plants are present at two positions in this web, and many arrows are coming out of it. That means this particular green plant is eaten by this one, and this one. Okay, so three organisms depend on this particular green plant. Again, this one eats this as well, and this is eaten by this one. So again, if we continue with this one, starting from this plant and this animal, and this animal is then eaten by this fox, and this fox also eats this small animal, and the fox is also the fox also eats this small animal right here. Okay, so it is a very complicated chain or network of connections of between the various trophic levels, feeding connections. Okay, so many organisms depend on many other organisms, and one plant or one organism can be eaten by many different organisms. It is like that. Okay, so here it is written, all possible energy paths are drawn here. Now, you will have to learn the definition of food web, and also you will have to learn the difference between food chain and food web. Here it is visually, you can get a visual idea from this one, but in your book, you will find the difference between food chain and food web. So the food chain is just one path, as you can see, just one path of energy starting from plant, herbivore, carnivore, another carnivore, another carnivore. There can be a decomposer as well. Okay, at the end there can be a decomposer. Okay, but here you already can see how many networks are, how many connections are there. So the difference between food chain and food web is important. You will have to learn it from the book. Okay.